Her hafta ilginç konusuyla Avukat Şadiye Arslan gündeminizi değiştiriyor. Bakalım bu haftaki konusu ne? Evet Şadiye.
Merhaba Fatoş. Arkamda İngiliz Parlamento binası var. Bu parlamentonun koridorlarına güç koridorları deniliyor. Bu koridorlarda Gordon Brown 6 Mayıs 2010 genel seçimlerinden sonra iki şey kaybetti. Birincisi başbakanlığı kaybetti. İkincisi İşçi Partisi liderliğini kaybetti. Peki yeni İşçi Partisi lideri kim olacak? Şu anda 5 tane aday var ve seçimlerin sonucu 25 Eylül 2010'da belli olacak. Biz bugün iki adayla görüşeceğiz. Biri David Miliband, diğeri ise Dan Abbott. Fakat gelin önce seçimler ile ilgili hazırladığımız VTR'yi izleyelim.
İşçi Partisi Mayıs 2010 seçimlerinden yenik çıktıktan sonra eski başbakan Gordon Brown'un istifa etmesiyle lidersiz de kaldı. Partinin liderliğine geçici olarak Harriet Herman atandı.
And goodbye.
Gordon Brown'dan boşalan koltuğu doldurmak için 5 aday kıyasıya yarışıyor. Adaylar Dan Abbott, Ed Balls, Andy Burnham, David Miliband, Ed Miliband. 25 Eylül'de sonuçlanacak İşçi Partisi liderlik seçimlerinde 3 kesim oy veriyor. Parlamento milletvekilleri, parti üyeleri ve sendikalar. Her kesimden gelen sonuç oyların sadece 3'te 1'ini oluşturacak. Bu 3 kesimin oylarının toplamının ortalaması İşçi Partisi'nin yeni liderini belirleyecek. Ayrıca İşçi Partisi'nin tarihinde bir ilk de bu seçimlerde yaşanıyor. Aralarında sadece 4 yaş olan iki kardeş David Miliband ve Ed Miliband liderlik koltuğunu kapmak için kıyasıya yarışıyorlar. Bu hafta Avukat Şadiye Arslan'a Türk televizyonlarında ilk defa iki İşçi Partisi lider adayları konuştu. Favori olarak gösterilen eski Dışişleri Bakanı David Miliband ve Hackney Milletvekili Dan Abbott, Muhafazakar Parti'nin yeni bütçesini eleştirdi ve liderlik yarışında iddialı olduklarını söylediler.
Şimdi İşçi Partisi liderliğine adaylığını koyan eski Dışişleri Bakanı David Miliband ile birlikteyiz. Ve seçimlerin sonucu 25 Eylül'de belli olacak. Hi David, how are you?
Very well, thank you. Nice to be with you.
It is late in the evening and you are still, I believe, campaigning for your Labour leadership. How is it going?
It's going very well. We've got a lot of energy and ideas and idealism out in the country. We're obviously not the government, so we're not the main news in Britain at the moment. We're going to have to rebuild ourselves from the bottom up.
Would you say that on 25th of September you will be the Labour leader, and do you really believe that?
I hope so, yes. But you can never take anything for granted. The great thing about democracy is that anything can happen. So we've got a big job to do in the Labour Party. We've got to oppose the government where we think they're doing things wrong, and we've got to begin to build an alternative government. That's a long process, but it's one that I think I can lead effectively.
As a member of Turkish and Kurdish speaking society, why should we vote for you rather than any other candidate? And also, do you get enough support from these communities?
I'm getting very good support from the diaspora communities of Britain. I think they want an internationalist leader of the Labour Party, someone who's committed to Britain being a place that people come to, but also that Britain plays a strong role in the world. And we've worked very closely together over the last 3 years, and that's, I think, a good basis on which to carry on our cooperation.
What do you think about the new budget? Do you think that it is going to hit one section of the society more? And what would you have done differently?
It's a risky budget and an unfair budget. It's risky because governments around Europe are cutting back on public spending, and the danger is that the very fragile recovery that started is snuffed out. That's the real danger. But it's also unfair because both on the spending side and on the taxation side, the government have not put the greatest burden on those with the broadest shoulders. They've, if anything, done the opposite. The poorer parts of society have had to pay a greater share of the price of the failures of the banking system, and that's obviously something that's deeply regressive.
Well, when you say broader shoulders, are you referring to corporation tax and are you referring to mansion tax?
Well, I think that the mansion tax would be a fair way of raising money. That would be on houses of more than £2 million a year. But we know that the value-added tax is a very regressive tax. We know that it can hit the poorest hardest unless they're compensated, which they haven't been in this case. And we also know that the government are targeting spending in a way that is going to hit the poorest hardest. And so when there is belt tightening to be done, it's not fair that it's done by those who are least able to do so.
Are you angry with Lib Dems for being part of such budget?
Yes, I think that the Liberal Democrats campaigned around the country as the party to keep the Conservatives out, and then they put the Conservatives in. And they campaigned around the country as the party to oppose the increase in VAT, and then they went and did it themselves. So that is not new politics, that is old politics, and it's quite dangerous and bad at that.
Given this election, and you are a Labour Party leader, and then in 2015, if you are Prime Minister, would you support Turkey's entry to European Union? And also there is a rumour that Turkey is getting closer to Iran. What do you say about that?
Well, I support Turkish entry into the European Union. But the process of European engagement with Turkey and Turkish engagement with Europe is not going as well as it should. And that reflects a range of factors. I don't think that Turkey is going to become a friend of Iran. That's not the point. Turkey is in Iran's neighborhood, but that's a different point. I think it's more important that we continue our efforts to make sure that Turkey, it's not a question of joining the West, it's a question of Turkey fulfilling its historic role of being a bridge between East and West, and that's something I would work for very hard indeed.
Just one last question. You do have a very young family, and you have election, and you've been busy. Are you going to have holiday this summer?
I'm definitely having holidays. We're definitely, we're enough of a European to definitely have 2 weeks holiday. Right. But it's tough not being able to see the children. I managed to get back to see them this afternoon, but it's tough. So don't make me cry.
No, I won't make you feel guilty or cry, and I hope that you do balance it out.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you. İngiltere'deki muhalefet partisi, yani İşçi Partisi'nde büyük bir liderlik yarışı yaşanıyor ve bu liderlik yarışının sonucu Eylül'de belli olacak. Liderlik yarışına katılanlardan biri de Diane Abbott. İngiltere'nin ilk siyah bayan milletvekilisi ve 1987'den itibaren kendisi milletvekili ve bu liderlik yarışı hakkında kendisiyle görüşmek istiyoruz. Hi Diane.
Hi.
In relation to this Labour leadership, when did you decide to go for it?
Well, it was after the election when I saw how narrow the field was. It was four males who were all the same. I mean, the same in their thinking, the same in their appearance, the same in their career. And I thought that the party, my party, deserved a better choice and a broader debate.
So you thought that they were not representing all of Labour voters?
No. What we had was four candidates who really represented the centre and the right of the party. There was no one from the centre left. And it's a very important debate we're going to have, you know, having lost the election. And I felt that the whole party deserved a voice.
I hope this might not come across harsh, but in the media it was written and in the other media it was said that you were only made a candidate in order to bring some diversity to the race, and that you did not have any chance to win. What do you say to that?
What I say to that is, when you look at the opinion polls, when they poll Labour voters about who they would want to see as Labour leader, I'm coming second. So it's not at all true I don't have any chance, and I may surprise some people. When I was a young girl, people told me I couldn't go to a top university. Then, as a woman, people told me I couldn't become a Member of Parliament. Everyone is saying I can't become leader of the party. So I just say, watch me and see.
Some people in Labour Party, either openly or in secret, from time to time express views that you are such a hard left-winger that you will end up making the mainstream voters running away. Do you agree with that?
Well, first of all, I think my views are quite mainstream. I think a lot of British people, not just leftists, had worries about the Iraq war and what happened afterwards. A lot of British people were worried about the money we spent bailing out the banks. So I think my views are quite mainstream. But I would say this, I present a television programme every week, which is watched by a lot of mainstream people. So I think I can appeal to the mainstream.
So you do see yourself having a big chance to win this leadership contest?
I certainly do. I am in it to win it.
My last question is going to be about Turkish-speaking community. And do you think that Turkish-speaking people in Labour Party will support you? And if so, why?
Well, I hope that they will look at my policies, and they will look on my record representing Turkish people, and I hope they will support me, because I think by being the first woman of an ethnic background to challenge for the very top position, I will pave the way for others, and maybe in 20 years time we'll be talking about a Turkish female leader of the Labour Party. Who knows?
You do live in Hackney, and I believe that you might even have some Turkish-speaking neighbors, Turkish-speaking shops. Yeah. Would you say that you know problems of Turkish-speaking community better than other candidates, or would that be unfair to other candidates?
No, I live and represent one of the biggest Turkish communities in the country, Turkish-Kurdish communities. I know far more about the Turkish community than other candidates because I've lived here, lived beside the community and represented the community for 23 years. So, I mean, I have a lot more knowledge than the other candidates. And I welcome the diversity and the economic improvements that the Turkish community has brought to Britain.
Thank you very much for joining us, and hopefully we can then enjoy your garden and have a cup of tea with you.
Thank you very much. Lovely to meet you.